Welcome to the digital poster irrigation detection over the Po River Valley, Italy, using Sentinel-1 radar backscatter observations. The quantification of the water used for agricultural purposes is a topic of critical importance nowadays, considering the effects of climate change and anthropogenic activities. The objective of this work is to derive irrigation assimilating the backscatter from Sentinel-1, both in VV and VH polarization, to update both soil moisture and vegetation into the NOAA-MP land surface model, which runs into the Land Information System framework. The NOAA-MP can run with and without an irrigation scheme turned on, and it is coupled with a water cloud model for the backscatter simulations. The study area is the Po River Valley in Italy, where we have collected irrigation data over 4 test sites called Brunel, Bodrio, San Michele Fosdondo, and Faenza. The NOAA-MP was set up at 1 km spatial resolution using MERRA2 as meteorological forcing input. Here are 2 maps of soil moisture and leaf area index simulations from NOAA-MP, and we can see that the patterns are mainly driven by the soil texture from the harmonized World Soil Database, which is an input for the model. First runs were evaluated through comparisons with in situ and remote sensing soil moisture and leaf area index observations. Results show acceptable agreements, but there are rooms of improvements updating both soil moisture and vegetation. Additionally, we have compared Sentinel-1 backscatter against irrigation data. Here, an example for the Bodrio test site. In the plots, backscatter observations, both in VV and VH polarization, are compared with the simulated soil moisture. Leaf area index is reported into the third plot and irrigation data into the bottom plot. The red arrow shows that during the summer, when the soil moisture drops down, the backscatter in VV signal grows, indicating a relation with the irrigation signal. On the other end, the green arrow shows that the VH signal better mimics the simulated leaf area index. Then we started to build up the proper data simulation system, and here you can see the equation of the water cloud model. The ingestion of Sentinel-1 observations requires 2 steps. The first one was to implement the water cloud model in LIS. The second one is the calibration of the water cloud model parameters, 2 vegetation parameters A and B, and 2 soil parameters C and D. The main problem here is how to preserve the irrigation signal into the data simulation system, and we found 2 options. Option 1, removing irrigated periods from the calibration, and option 2, activating an irrigation scheme into NOAA-MP. For the first option, here are 2 examples of calibrated parameters related to a single pixel and a clustering calibration in the first and second line respectively. We found 3 calibration issues here. So the first one is that the calibration is sensitive to different objective functions, a saturation of the vegetation parameters on upper boundaries and wrongly simulated summer peaks. In the clustering calibration, finally, this saturation is reflected over a huge number of pixels, where we have wrong simulations. For the second option, we activated the irrigation scheme into NOAA-MP, and you can see the simulations in the right panel. In particular, the irrigation signal is reported in light blue in the bottom right plot. We can see that in these new simulations, the soil moisture is more consistent with the Sentinel-1 signal, in particular VV polarization, and that the leaf area index was also modified by the irrigation simulation, and this can provide the optimal calibration of the water cloud model. In conclusion, evaluation of NOAA-MP runs showed that the importance of updating both soil moisture and vegetation, the calibration of water cloud model is a key step for building a robust data simulation system, and activating an irrigation scheme can provide the optimal calibration of the water cloud model. For the next step, we will derive irrigation from data simulation diagnostic, and particularly updating both soil moisture and vegetation. We will use a filter or smoother for the optimization, but this is still a work in progress. So thank you for your attention.